Welcome to TI's Troubleshooting Tips series. When returning TI components, it's important to reference TI's quality and reliability processes that can be found on ti.com/quality. For more troubleshooting information, please refer to ti.com/troubleshooting. Do you suspect a TI product to be non-conforming to datasheet electrical, mechanical or image quality specification and would like to learn more on TI's return process? Then this troubleshooting tip series will give you helpful guidelines when returning a product to TI. Here's an overview of the 5 key items of TI's guidelines for returns. The removal and manual handling of electronic components pose the risk of physical damage that may result in untestable conditions. This video will provide you with beneficial guidelines when it comes to preparing board and packages, as well as desoldering a product from your printed circuit board, short PCB. Before performing first crush checks on the suspect TI product or returning it to TI for verification and analysis, the component must be carefully removed from the customer PCB. Why is this such a critical step? The plastic mold compound of surface mount technology, or short SMT packages, are soaking humidity to some extent. A rapid increase in temperature of the package to the desoldering temperatures while the package is loaded with moisture may damage the suspect TI product. Delamination can occur inside the package as the moisture turns to steam, building up pressure inside the component and in worst cases causing lifted bond wires or package damages, as shown in these images. These defects will mask the true root cause. Therefore, following these guidelines to remove a suspect TI product will maximize the chances to find and correct the root cause of an issue. So, how to prevent moisture-induced damages? It is highly recommended to bake the PCBs and electronic components prior to any rework, especially if the removed component is needed for further failure analysis. The recommended temperature depends on the maximum temperatures that the components and the PCB can withstand without damage. In general, the recommended bake conditions for SMT packages are 8 to 24 hours at 105 to 125 degrees Celsius. Automatic desoldering of any electronic component is recommended to control the temperature of the package during the rework process. This means either using equipment that can measure the package temperature by infrared thermography or using a small thermocouple attached to the top side of the package. Ideally would be a rework station allowing control of the soldering temperature according to the JEDEC soldering profile. When you remove the TI product, be careful not to cut off the pins, as that would prevent any further electrical testing. Here is an example of how an IC package can be removed from a PCB without damaging the component. The following images show a mounting commercial rework station. Thermocouples are placed on the IC package to monitor the rework temperature profile. These are glued on the package top side, lead top side and adjacent PCB, which ensures correct temperature readings. Remember to protect temperature-sensitive components and remove any batteries from the board. Aluminum foil can be used for shielding. The components are heated up with hot air from top and infrared from bottom. Select the appropriate temperature profile according to the component that is being desoldered. The component's datasheet includes the needed specs. After the lead temperature reaches the solder's liquid temperature, the picker is moved over the component to remove it from the board using vacuum. Remember, it's extremely important to ensure care is taken during the desoldering and resoldering processes. Proper soldering and removal of the component from the PCB is critical for the next step of verifying and confirming the issue on the TI product. Patience and due diligence is required to safely remove components from the non-conforming PCB. And finally, it's important to emphasize that electrical measurements may depend on the cleanliness of the PCB. Excessive flux contamination, for example, may alter your precision measurements. Please remove solder flux and other board contaminations to avoid parasitic effects during measurements. Board and component cleanliness should be monitored during the desoldering and soldering process. Here's an example of how excessive flux contamination can cause DC voltage errors. The graph shown on the right represents the electrical measurements over time of three examples: unclean system, hand cleaned, and cleaned using an ultrasonic bath. The output voltage of the system was recorded for 60 minutes in all three cases. It is critical to note the output voltage over time for each example. Red represents the board when no cleaning is applied. Gray represents a hand cleaned board, and for blue we used an ultrasonic bath to clean the PCB. The output voltage appeared unpredictable during the measurement process when no cleaning was applied to the board. A DC offset and a periodic spike was seen when only a hand cleaned method was used to remove excessive contaminants. However, use of an ultrasonic bath to remove excessive flux resulted in a smooth single-centered measurement around approximately 2.5 volts. Therefore, remember to always clean and inspect board and components after each desoldering and soldering process step. Now that we covered this part of TI's guidelines for returns, it is important to mention that TI's additional collateral on TI.com to help with troubleshooting and debugging. As shown here in the slide, you find additional support and information on TI's quality policies and processes, as well as an E2E support forum and TI Precision Labs. Thank you for watching this series on guidelines for returns. For additional videos, please visit ti.com/troubleshooting.